course, you gather with brothers in fellowship. You admonish. You know, you have to correct brothers at times and rebuke them. You know, and also comfort brothers. But what's at the forefront of those things? Prophesying. Prophecy is what drives the ministry. It spearheads the testimony of our Lord Yahweh Shah. And that can be proven by going right here to the book of Ecclesiasticus, the 39th chapter. And the first verse, it says, but he that giveth his mind to the law of the Most High. Now, whenever we come across this word law, we have to qualify, you know, as touching context. Because you actually have certain men amongst Israel, these self-proclaimed teachers and leaders amongst Israel, who place the burden of keeping the law at the foot of fellow Israelites. You know, for an example, these guys, IUIC, I know there's a branch in this city in the one video that I was able to stomach, right? Well, in that video, they was holding camp and they had a certain brother, you know, who I perceive to be sincere, who was inquiring of the truth, and he asked them, what shall he do? And the first thing they said was that he had to keep the law, which was a very irresponsible approach. And ultimately, it testified to them erring, not knowing the scriptures. Look, keeping the law in its entirety here in his lifetime is a feat none of us can accomplish. So what does it mean when the scriptures say, he that giveth his mind to the law of the Most High? Well, here in his lifetime, that law consists of this book in its entirety. For an example, when you read the book of Romans, the third chapter, it speaks about the law of faith. So it's commanded